Animal Crossing New Horizons is one of the most anticipated Nintendo games of all time, so the hype is bringing a lot of new players into the series. If you've never played an Animal Crossing game before, it can be a very daunting experience from the amount of freedom that you have inside the game. So this guide is to give new players some direction to understand how Animal Crossing works. Also, New Horizons can be tricky for even existing Animal Crossing fans from my experience, so this video is to help them out as well. Either way, if you ended up enjoying the video, or if it helps you in any way, please leave a like and share this video with all your friends on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Discord. It greatly helps. So this guide is going to show you the fastest ways to get the house, keyring, advanced crafting recipes, as well as just give you some general good advice. These are the most important things for the beginning of the game, because the house gives you access to storage, the key ring gives you instant access to all of your tools, recipes like the pole vault are needed to explore the island and even progress through the game. There's also a lot more benefits that I'll talk about later on this video, and some you'll discover for yourself. Even though it goes against the philosophy of Animal Crossing to rush content or take the game too seriously, I believe it's 10,000,000,000% worth it for the first hour of gameplay to be a tryhard. So, let's get into exactly what you need to do. The very beginning of the game is pretty straightforward and effectively takes place on day 0. So you get an introduction from Tom Nook and you also receive a tent. You can place this tent wherever you like. If you like the scenery, if you think it's by a lot of resources, you can plop it down there, and then you also get two more tents for your animal friends. These are townsfolk, you can just kind of put them anywhere as well, depending on how fast you just want to get through the game. Sometimes sloppy tent and house placement can mess you up, but this guide isn't about that. It's not about like optimizing your perfect island, it's just kind of getting you to a really good state in the game as fast as possible. So find some places to throw down those tents, and then what you want to do is grab 10 sticks and 6 fruit. The 10 sticks will be needed to make a fire, the 6 fruit will be for a little snack, and then that is where the game truly begins. So if you ever need like any help, or if you want to get caught up with everything, talk to Tom Nook, he'll tell you what to do, but these are the first resources that you need to get, the 10 sticks, 6 fruit. So Animal Crossing takes place in real time, so 1 minute in the game is 1 minute in real life. It's very unique in that aspect, and you can like change the time clock on your Nintendo Switch to skip ahead in the days, and we will be utilizing that through this guide, but it doesn't really matter at this very moment. Now, when you wake up on day one, you're going to learn that you owe this raccoon a lot of money. So the main currency in the game is known as bells, and then there's also a sub-currency known as Nook Miles. Now, Nook Miles are going to be the most important part in the early game, because once you reach those 5,000 Nook Miles, that is how you unlock the house. Also, when you receive 800 more Nook Miles, then you can unlock the key ring, and the rest of the game is going to be a lot easier. So that is what we are going to be prioritizing, but the first thing you want to do is head back to the main plaza, go into the green tent, and this will unlock crafting. So crafting gives you access to making a fishing pole as well as a bug net, and you can even buy them from the little raccoons as well. The beginning of the game is also going to be a bit of a dance between bells and Nook Miles. You need bells to buy tools and also kind of get a really good acceleration on unlocking Nook Miles, and then Nook Miles are still the most important thing at this time. So what I recommend is going out and picking about 200 weeds. It sounds pretty crazy, but it doesn't take a lot of time. You also want to harvest all of the fruit on all of the trees that you can see. Side note, your native fruit may vary. Mine are cherries, you can have any of the other fruits possible inside the game. It doesn't really change anything, that is just going to be your primary fruit. So if I say cherries and you have peaches or something, just change that to peaches because it's all the same since your own individual island will vary. So once you have those weeds and the fruit, you want to sell them to the Nookling, and that is going to give you a lot of bells. You can also sell your Nintendo Switch that you get as a gift from Nintendo in the mail, because it's worth an insane amount of money, and it's really going to help out your early game. Now, I don't know how or if you can get another one inside the games, so if you're really attached to it, maybe hold on to it, but if you only care about accelerating the early game and you don't really care about it too much, it's absolutely worth selling. So what we can do is buy tools and recipes from the Nookling, and that's going to be really nice. So you can start off with a fishing pole, with a butterfly net, and then you can also pick up sticks, craft them yourself, crafting eventually unlocks Nook Miles, catching fish unlocks Nook Miles, and then getting bugs as well. So you want to catch like 10 bugs, 10 fish, get as many different species as you can. And then inside of the green tent, there's the Nook Terminal. So interacting with that will give you 50 miles. It gives you miles every single day. That's a thing. Here's a little bit of cheese I found as well, that there's a Nook Mile achievement for exterior decorator. If you just pick up an item and put it outside and then pick it up and put it outside, it will actually count towards that achievement. So you just have to do that 10 times. I did it with my Nintendo Switch, and then I sold my Nintendo Switch and it was okay. And then the rest of it is effectively going to be the big miles grind. You want to constantly be checking your Nook phone to see what you can do. But there's so many possibilities. Like, I was getting hundreds and thousands of Nook Miles just for playing the game regularly. That's why I said go pick up 200 weeds, because 200 weeds are two achievements for Nook Miles. And then when you're catching fish, that's going to work as well. Try to get a catch combo of 10. So as long as you catch fish without like scaring them off, that's going to progress towards that. That's a few hundred Nook Miles right there. So just kind of like doing as much as possible, as long as it's going to end up with Nook Miles, and pretty much everything ends up giving you Nook Miles. Now, once you've gotten 5 different species of fish and or bugs, you show them to Tom Nook. And that's also where talking to Tom Nook regularly can help you out, because he is effectively the path progression. If he says to do something and you're lost, do that, and then that's going to put you right back on track. So you show him 5 different species of fish or bugs, and then that is going to unlock Blathers and the axe. So you get the axe at 2, but I'd say you just get all 5 of them at once, and then that's when you get a tent for Blathers. You set that up. By the next day, he's going to come. That's going to be another big part of the progression. So do that, and that's effectively going to be your day 1. You can get the 5,000 Nook Miles that you need to buy the house on day 1, even if you don't have full access to the island. It's pretty crazy like that. I ended up doing it on day 2 because I made a lot of mistakes. I wasn't as aggressive as I should have been. You can buy flower seeds. You plant 10 of those, that's going to be a couple hundred Nook Miles right there. I didn't catch the 10 fish. I was lazy and didn't catch enough bugs. So as long as you just kind of meet the baseline achievements, you're going to get the thousands of Nook Miles that you need, and then you can do your first time skip. So time skip is very straightforward. If you've done in Pokemon Sword and Shield, it's the same. If you've ever changed the clock for your Nintendo Switch, it's going to be the same. So you want to go to options, you want to go all the way down, it says date and time, and then you need to turn the sync off. So you turn off synchronization, you can manually move the day forward 1, and then that's going to be good to go. However, inside your game, you need to quit out properly. So you press the minus button, that's going to end the game. You go to the title screen of your game, and then you go to the homepage on Nintendo Switch. You have to restart your game. You have to restart the game, do the time skip, go back into your game, and then Tom Nook will have the daily message, which means you did a successful time skip. That means Blather's tent should be set up. Now, we still have a lot to do, but that should be a really good way to optimize your first day. And even if you don't get the 5,000 miles, don't worry about it. You can just pick up the last couple hundred really quickly. This should take about an hour and probably less if you are getting a really good feel for the game. So now we're in day 2. The first thing you want to do is talk to Blathers, because he will give you the recipe for the pole vault and the shovel. These are major upgrades. Shovel is going to be for fossils. You need the fossils to get the full-on museum. That's going to have a lot of perks behind it. But the most important thing is going to be the pole vault, because by using the pole vault, you can get over the river. That unlocks a lot more exploration for the island. And then with the shovel, you can mine rocks. The rocks will give you iron and gold, and then you can use that to upgrade your tools. Quick note, the faster you hit the rock, the more resources you are going to get. That it's time-based, and you can only hit that rock once per day. So keep note of that, but it's going to be really good for getting the early stuff set up. Now, this is where the axe comes into play. You don't really need to use it on your first day, but the axe does reward you with Nook Miles if you do get a lot of wood. So pretty much, since this is now a crafting-based Animal Crossing, you just need to hoard all the resources that you can. It's okay to sell weeds, it's okay to sell fruit, but don't sell wood, don't sell sticks, don't sell stones. Just kind of accumulate everything, get the Nook Miles, and then start crafting and start progressing further into the game. But either way, you can like make the pole vault, you can make the shovel without too much hassle, and then you have your 5,000 Nook miles. So once you talk to Blathers, it's going to be easier to get more miles. And now it's time to talk to Tom Nook. So the 5,000 miles are to pay off just the tent. When it comes to Tom Nook, everything's about the future. Everything's a loan. So 5,000, that's going to get you caught up. But then he entices you with a house. And you say yes to that house, and that's going to put you even further in debt. And what I recommend is to take the bells option, because like I said, Nook Miles are going to be incredibly important in the beginning of the game, but I also like the other perks that Nook Miles give, so I don't want to have the cost of the house in Nook Miles kind of distracting from that. So you can play the bells game for the house, and then you can play the miles game for the rest of the unlocks, and I think that's going to be a pretty good progression. But what you have to do is you have to talk to Tom Nook, you have to say you want the house, you have to go into debt, and then that signs you up for the Nook Miles Plus program, and this is where the game gets even better and even easier, but also unlocks a lot more stuff that you have to do. So when you talk to the Nook Terminal after that, you'll see that the Nook Miles Plus has unlocked, and then for 800 Nook Miles, you can get the Tool Ring. And that's what the key is. So you get the house, that unlocks the Tool Ring, and then the next time you time skip, your house will be built, so then you can use that for storage. Since you're running out of pocket space, you can also use the Nook Miles Plus program to get the 5,000 miles to then unlock your pockets, and the games are going to be easier. But that's going to be another guide, so you might also want to consider subscribing or checking out the playlist in the description down below, maybe some of my other videos to help you out with future stuff about the content. Because that's pretty much it for this video. Like I said, fast Tool Ring, fast house, try to have no nonsense. Getting the last 800 Nook Miles is effectively going to be easier, because if you look at the top, you have a rolling task list that you can do. So you can just do repeatable tasks for small amounts of Nook Miles. Definitely worth it to do a few of those to get the 800, or if you still have like a lot of other ones to cash in just from general resource grinding and island exploration, you might have 5,800 by the time you actually talk to Tom Nook for the house. Then the first thing you want is the Tool Ring, and then after that it's going to be about getting the special tools, or like the better tools upgrades, expanding your pockets, so on so forth, getting the bells, paying off your house. But like I said, more advanced guides about that on the way. So if you guys enjoy the video, hope you all have a nice day. Thank you very much for watching.